In previous sessions, we have seen how to create dashboard by using templates. And if you remember, initially when we were learning about creating the applications, let me show you. Whenever you want to create a new application in your CRM Analytics platform, what you do in Analytics Studio, you go to here, create app. And there you can see, I will get multiple options like create a blank applications, which we did before. And then you can see creating application using different template. So many templates are given by Salesforce to do it. So now, when you say the template, what it mean? So now, this is already given with some dashboard, data set, lens, everything is inbuilt. You can use it. Okay. For example, I'm going to show you two nice template to be used, which I'm going to create a dashboard from it, like a complete application from it. We'll see what is going to happen when I'm going to use this template to create any of the applications. Okay. So now, for example, I am going to talk about sales analytics template and service analytics template. Okay. So I'm going to create a new application using the template. If you see here, we have customer insight analytics, you have design style, Einstein discovery, service analytics, sales analytics, revenue operations. Like this, many templates are given. Okay. For appointment, approval, B2B commerce, change analytics, campaign, event monitoring. If you see for field services, we have field service analytics. Many more things are there. So depending on what kind of template you want to use, you can pick from here. Even if you want, you can search from this search. For example, I want to get my sales analytics. You can see here, I can search it out. Okay. And if you see, there is a filter options to filter with tags. Okay. It's for sales, for design, for the Einstein. So many more things are there. So now, whenever you want to create an application using a template, what's happening? Let's understand that. Okay. And this is we are going to understand by using a sales analytics template. So now, instead of creating a blank application, I'm creating an application using a predefined template given by Salesforce. When I say sales analytics template, what it mean? It gives the power of analytics to your sales cloud. Okay. What it mean? So let me select it, then you'll understand. So if you see the description of it, the latest version of the app going to help you entire sales team to unlock the power of sales cloud data. On top of sales cloud data, this template will help you to give the dashboard, data set, everything. Okay. So if you see this tag, this will be usually used for sales, trending, customer 360. If you select this one and click on continue, then we'll see one nice thing. What is this thing? If like whenever you are going to use any template for the application, read this left side. What this template contains. So now, sales analytics, when you say this is currently in the version 5.0, the latest version of the app, which helps you, your entire sales team, unlock the full power of sales cloud data. Okay. So what are the features available here? So this is a embeddable dashboard available. This is mobile ready, pre-built dashboard, pre-built lens are there. Data flow already there and KPI dashboards are there. So these dashboards built on top of which object? Sales cloud data object, correct? You can see here full of sales cloud data. It means it have account object, opportunity, opportunity split, opportunity line item, opportunity product scheduled, opportunity history, product, price book. You can see all the object, opportunity team member, account team member, lead, task, event, case, campaign, campaign member, forecasting item, user, user role. On top of this Salesforce object, this template is ready. Okay, what it will do? So it will have a sales analytics home. It will start exploring sales analytics with overview of top level year to date performance indicator, KPI. You can see like this KPI dashboard available for you. There is a leaderboard available also. like this trending pipeline changes for a given period, that trending dashboard you can see, sales by stage analysis you can see. So everything you can see what is there or not. Okay. So once you go through, if you're okay, you can click on continue. The moment you click on continue, what is going to happen? Now it will ask, do you want to create this application as a brand new applications, or do you want to add in any of existing application? No, I want to create as a brand new applications. Okay, so I'm going to create a brand new app, select this one, click continue. Okay, now, so whenever this is happening, it will do some check in our system. Okay, so this kind of requirement met or not, if you see here, like your org meet minimum requirement for creating the application, like it should have at least one account record, opportunity record, task record. If not there, then it will not be able to create it. So that minimum requirement check. So what are the objects looking for this, that objects are available or not, field are accessible by this analytics user or not. Okay, so if all data looks good, then we can say, okay, all okay. If something is missing, then it will be fail here. Okay, so now we can go to looks good next. So now what type of, like how you want to create this sales analytics application? So now there is two things. You can create it as a basic application, or you can create it as a custom applications. I'm going to show you with basic application first. So you can see it will use all the default setting, or you can say standard setting. Using that, it will create application. Or if you want to make the custom, you can choose what to be reflect or not, how you want to preview the data, that you can choose. Let's go with basic now. Select this one, then click looks good next. The moment you say, now it will tell me, give the application name. I'm giving the application name as Sales Analytics, my application name. Okay. Now click on the create. So now it takes few minutes of time. So once you create, what happened? It will create the application, build all the dashboard, whatever you have, the inbuilt data set, whatever you have, everything will be built. Okay. So now you can see this is process is running. So now whenever we say this sales analytics, what it mean? It means Salesforce created sales analytics to make it easy to analyze your sales cloud data. This brings the power from the sales cloud data, which supports in any device. It gives initiative visualizations based on data what you have. Okay, so you can do, your sales team can do the insight and take quickly action on this. Okay, so now you can see this takes some time. So I'm not going to wait for this. So you can also leave for 5 minutes or 2 minutes, depending on the volume of data, what you have. It's going to create data set, it's going to create the data flow, it's going to create external data, everything. So this information is how it's going on. If you want to check, as usual, you can go to your data manager. In data manager, you can see the jobs running. So if you see here, it says, see data manager, all these jobs are in running to see how it's happening off. Okay. Let me do one thing here. You can see it's running. So I'm just stopping the session here right now. Once this job ran successfully, then we'll see what is happening. Thank you. Stay tuned for next session.